Germany. I'm 21 years old and I'm a student and I study intercultural management and communication.
Hello, my name is Julian. I'm from England, a town in the southwest called Cheltenham. I'm 18 years old and my project is teaching English.
Oh, hello, I'm John from England. I'm 24 and I've been teaching for 3 weeks.
Hi, future BPP volunteers. My name is Karen Elson, 24 years old. I am from the United States, from Long Island, New York, and I came here to volunteer for 3 weeks. I was placed here teaching English. I was here for 3 weeks teaching university students, working on their pronunciation, teaching them about my culture, learning about their culture from them as well. And I absolutely love my experience.
So the project is teaching English to university students, just something which is organised in the summer by BPV. And it involves that most of them are fairly fluent in the language, so it's about improving their pronunciation or vocabulary knowledge and things like that. And we do reading and writing and listening and things like that with them.
So I have students who go to university who want to like improve their English, and they are like between 17 and 24 years old, and they come to the summer class like in their holidays.
And we had different groups each day in the morning and the afternoon. So we basically taught them pronunciation, we did lots of tongue twisters with them, had them read articles, and just taught them a lot about our culture, and they in turn taught us a lot about their culture. It was really nice to also do things outside of the classroom with the students. They invited us to dinners, tours around the city, and it was nice to meet with them outside of the classroom and really get to know them as a person, their family life, their culture, and where they're from.
We either have a class in the morning or afternoon. Sometimes both, for like 2 hours, just teaching university students. Sweet conversation. So it's not that hard to do.
Okay, so five big black bear brush broke. Good job.
Five big black bear brush broke.
Red. Red, very good.
Red. Very good. Red.
Okay, thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Some months ago, I read an article about volunteering, and it was about volunteering in Asia and volunteering in Africa. And this article touched me very much. And so I wanted to do volunteering myself. And I did a lot of research on the internet. I read from other volunteers, and that it was really a great like experience for them. And so I found this project here in Vietnam. And I decided to do volunteer because in my life there were a lot of teachers. They helped me to like reach the goals I had that I'm able to study. And I want to go to a country where people don't have so many opportunities and like just help them and give a part for me to them so that they can develop and achieve their goal.
I first decided I wanted to volunteer last November, I think it was, because I didn't have anything. I had a really boring summer last year where I just stayed in England, and I thought I want to do something different next year, and so I thought it would be good, and I couldn't find anyone directly to go travelling with, so I thought volunteering would be a good idea, do some work in the country, then have some time at the end to go travelling. So that's what I thought, and Vietnam is a place I've always been interested in going to, so I thought I could try and combine the two, and that's how I ended up finding.
Before I came here, I volunteered in Tanzania for 4.5 months. Completely different experience from here. When I went to Tanzania, it was the first time I had ever gone abroad. I had no idea what I was in for, and I picked one of the most underdeveloped places to go. I was teaching English in a school there, and on my first day there, I arrived. I was introduced to the director of the school. He brought me into my classroom and said, "Here are your students. Okay, goodbye." I didn't know if the students could speak English. I didn't have any materials. The school had no books. They had no blackboards. They had nothing to work with. I had one textbook dated 1967, some crappy-ass science book, and that was all I had.
Well, this is the second time, and it was Vietnam because this is where we ended up. We only booked it about a week before we came here because we were traveling. We were already in Vietnam at the time and didn't want to travel anymore. It's been good.
And that is one of the good things about volunteering. You get to meet people from different walks of life. People that you normally wouldn't be friends with at home, but you come to places like this and they become lifelong friends.
Yeah, I think it's good. So you can definitely tell that you've made a contribution to the volunteer, to the students that we've been teaching. And it's, yeah, it's always good to help the other people there who work as they want to learn English and they're keen to learn. So it's good that there's somebody there to teach them.
And I think I would everyone recommend to do volunteer work, even if it's just helping children, like for example in the orphanages, like playing with children. They're just so happy to have someone, and yeah, I really recommend that. I feel very happy about it that I did this decision.
My first feeling was, I think I'm going to die, because in the car from the airport to the Peace House, it was quite scary because it was dark, and all I could see was headlights coming towards me on both sides of the roads, and it seemed like we were going to crash.
When I arrived in Hanoi, the first thing I noticed was this big heat, and it was like a wall hitting me.
Yeah.
And there was this special smell in the air, what you can smell everywhere. And I went in the cab, and we were driving, and then the next thing I saw was just a crazy traffic. It was so many motorbikes and people transporting a lot of big things on the bike, and there was full of rice fields and people working on the rice fields, and it was like the first impression on the way to Hanoi. But being in Hanoi was just really chaotic and crazy, a lot of workers, street sellers, and a lot of traffic.
It's nice, it's really pretty country.
Here's the word, guys.
Traveled around it a lot, gone to lots of different places. People are mostly friendly.
Vietnam in general, don't judge a book by its cover. When you first get here, you're a little hesitant. You don't necessarily have the best impressions of Vietnam and the people. Give it time, and eventually you will fall in love with it.
We went to some trips together with other volunteers, so I was a group with around 8 people. And we went together to Sapa, which is in the north. It's like a village up in the mountains.
Well, I traveled with Tara before we came here for about 3 weeks up from the side, all the way up to Hanoi through Ho Chi Minh, Hoi An,
I did Ha Long Bay, which was beautiful. 2 days, 1 night on a boat. It's nice to be able to swim in the water because it's so damn hot here. But my favorite city in Vietnam is Hoi An.
Right.
Old city, quaint town, lots of tailors to make cheap clothes, beautiful beach. You can rent a bicycle and just bicycle around the town, and it's a really beautiful place.
Next week, well, Friday when I leave Hanoi, I'm going to fly down to Hoi and stay there for a few days and then go to Hoi An. So I'll stay on the coast, which will be nice, a nice change from the Hanoi air. So it'd be nice to see some different areas in Vietnam.
Oh, this building behind me is the Peace House, and it's the place I'm staying during my volunteer work. And it's really beautiful because there are so many people, like other volunteers, staying, and it just feels like a big family. Everyone knows each other. And when you wake up and you see the first person, you just greet them, you go down, you catch your breakfast, and we are a very spontaneous group, so sometimes we have water fights with water pistols, or we order pizza together, and it kind of feels like home, because really everyone is so close, and everyone is working for the same goals, and it's just trying to achieve these goals, and it makes you very close.
My first feeling was, it's a bit different to my house at home, because it's quite a rustic building, some bits are quite dirty. But you get used to it after a while, and it's fine, it's everything's comfy and fairly clean. So it's a good place to live for a few weeks, and it's good living with all the other volunteers, so there's always someone to talk to, so you never get lonely here.
Yeah,
that's
nice really. Yeah, having Wi-Fi and laundry is good.
Yeah, but I think Peace House is a good place to live for your time in Vietnam. Interesting experience with all sorts of new things being discovered and seen and explored, and definitely something I'd like to do again in the future.